Hey friends, we're going to do a breaking down the score of Epiphany from Sweeney Todd. My last video, we did Wait from Sweeney Todd. You should probably watch that first, so that way you have some context for what I'm going to talk about in this video. You can purchase this score in full, I believe, from Hal Leonard. I have a hard copy of this, but we're going to use the digital version for now, so that way it makes it easier. If you remember, in Wait, we had that piano theme. Well, that's now making a new reappearance. Okay, Mrs. Lovett was trying to calm him down during Wait because he really wants to kill the judge and get revenge for being locked up. But now, at the beginning of Epiphany, it says agitato, which means agitated. It's much faster, but it's the same theme now in a new key, which is kind of like Sweeney's brooding and like anticipated murder plight to like kill the judge. But now it's much faster. And it gets like really crazy. This is when he loses his crap and he flies off the handle. And we have this main theme going on with an F in the bass here. Todd interrupts. He says, I had him. Now, I don't ever hear people singing it. Just because there's so much chaos going on, they mostly act this part. His throat was bared beneath my hand. He says, no, I had him. His throat was there and he'll never come again. And then she goes back into her theme from Wait. Easy now, hush, love, hush. I keep telling you. Then he screams, when, what's your rush? Why did I wait? Now he's pissed at her. She's like, why did I listen to you? But during this moment, again, in the orchestra, you have these really crunchy chords that are just, like, really nasty. So while she's singing the easy now, easy now, hush, love, hush, I keep telling you, bass no hit, when, what's your rush? It's a lot to play and sing at the same time. That's why you need an orchestra. Now he'll never come again. Now it goes into a totally new melodic note. Now he'll never come again. Whole tone. Text painting with the action. He's going bananas. That's his breaking point. Now he'll never come again. Then you have... There's a hole in a world like a great black pit, and it's filled with people who are filled with shit, and the vermin of the world inhabit it. Then you hear bum, 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 but not for, and that theme again comes back, bum, 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 but not for long. Now, I think I've talked about this in another video at some point, but there's this Dies Irae. I talk about it all the time. It's probably my favorite part of this show is how stitched together this entire score is to the Dies Irae. If you don't know, it's that. Gregorian chant, Day of Wrath. That's what that means. So now it's in the right hand here of the piano, but in the lower notes right here. This is the Dies Irae right there. Chugging along. Bum 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 bum. Just kind of fitting, because now listen to what he's saying. They all deserve to die. Tell you why, Mrs. Lovett, tell you why. He's kind of been silent this whole time, and this is like just a big cathartic moment. You got all these crunchy chords going on. Now we go into that theme again, you know? But it's kind of broken up here. I never really hear anybody sing these notes the right way. Myself included. All this crunchy stuff. Back to the Dies Irae, and then he goes even higher with the melody. All deserve to die. Even you, Mrs. Lovett, even I. So it's the same melody, but there's a little bit of differences going on here. We have a lot of stuff going on melodically. It's just a lot. You just gotta learn the notes. It's like an opera. Because the lives of the wicked should be made brief. Slashes in the air, kind of goes with the orchestra. Now we have a little bit of key change with the all deserve to die. Keeps getting higher with that melody. Now, here's his Lucy theme, which happens earlier in the show. And now he's back into his mode of like, oh my God, I'm never going to see my daughter again. And I'll never see Joanna with this minor second trill going on. No, I'll never hug my girl to me. Finished. Then he just breaks out of the rhythm there. You notice it's the same theme now, but it's broken out. Another augmentation of the rhythm. All right. You, sir, how about a shave? Come and visit your good friend Sweeney. You, sir, too, sir. Welcome to the grave. I will have vengeance. There's his theme with Joanna. I will have vengeance. I will have salvation. You could see how it's like going all or nothing with his like psyche. He's going to that lush na da 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 into that. He's just losing his mind. Gentlemen, now don't be shy. Not one man. New key. No, nor 10 men, nor 100 can assuage me. I will have you. And now we go into this march. And then he says to Mrs. Lovett, softly, and I will get them back even as he gloats. In the meantime, I'll practice on less honorable throats. And then he goes into another new key, and my Lucy lies in ashes. But the work, now listen to this chord. You have that with a half step trill. Just a bunch of cluster chords here. And alive at last, and I'm full of joy. Finally, really happy, full of joy, dissonant chord. And we finally end with a B flat, but then maybe not so much. So there's a lot going on in this, but this is the cathartic moment. And you could hear it in the music, how it alternates between going out of his mind and yearning for Lucy and Joanna and what he's lost. Probably one of the hardest songs in the show. Once you get it, you get it. And it's a lot of fun. Anyway, friends, hope you have a great day. I will talk to you soon. Bye.